Guys, it's Lumberman. I'm doing the Todd DLC character pack review. And this one is, well, I'm just going to be reviewing the classic character pack. Now, out of all of these, I think this one has the most generic characters because the whole idea of it is just based on the old minifigs. Also, I'm going to be including Obi-Wan, even though you only get him if you pre-ordered the game. So I'm just going to get him over one.
Hello there. Don't be afraid.
It's basically just the same as old Obi-Wan. Novel. But yeah, he's quite fun to use. Well, all the Jedi characters are. I don't think there's anything really different other than how he looks. So I'm gonna... Not with any of the characters, so I'm mainly just going to be reviewing them on how they look. He looks cool. Mean beard on him. Cool. Now we get Jedi Luke Skywalker.
And I'm a Jedi, like my father before us.
Cool. But yeah, he's pretty cool looking. Kind of weird to see him with the HD lightsaber. But I don't think any of these guys have much detail on them. I don't need a mentor, so. So that's two. I'm gonna keep track of how many I've done because in the Troopers video, I wasn't sure if it was done or not. I went back and checked and yes, I was done. Okay, yeah, classic player.
We cannot let the Empire triumph. The Alliance will prevail.
This is actually one of the few classic Star Wars minifigs that I actually have. I actually like that they use the old blasters in this. But, yeah, just because the blaster looks different, it doesn't actually function any different. This DLC is more about the nostalgia than this the characters themselves. But also, yes, I am gonna try to do as many as I can back to back. Why is it going red there? I don't know. Okay, so I should probably like research this before I do it, but I don't. Okay, next we have Classic Han.
We gonna do this or what?
Again, normal blaster. This should be faster than normal. No, it's not. I have to say, I actually really like the classes of console on minifigure. Yeah, he just fights like normal Han. Also, might I recommend leaving a like and a sub if you like LEGO Star Wars and you want more content. But yeah, I actually like how this looks. Long story short, I like how classic characters look. So, is that four? I think I've done so. But now I'm not sure who could be left. Oh, classic Vader.
This will be a day long remembered.
This is my favorite classic figure. I don't know why, but I just really like how classic Vader looks. Let's see, you can't actually see what the face looks like, but you can see they actually took the time to model it, so he's using the old grey face print. From well when this minifig was around. Anyway, you know what? I'm gonna do Rogue One DLC in this video as well. I don't know, I'm kind of not in the mood to upload 4 videos today, so I'm gonna do 3. So, Rogue One. I haven't actually looked at any of the Rogue One characters yet. I don't think there's any new Jedi. No. I think most of them are in the Heroes tab. Okay. Baz Malbus. I haven't actually seen much of Rogue One recently. I watched it, but I don't know who most of the people are. This gun looks really cool, but it just shoots like a normal one. I kind of wish they did something special with this gun. But... at least he can use that.
Where may I go?
But he... again, fairly normal gun. Okay, he's got the grapple attacks. I like him. I'm gonna go inside because it's a lot easier to see the characters inside. That's why I chose Kamino. That and the just little long heads. I'm watching them panic. So let's help me, that is. What you reading? Nothing, I guess, but. Yeah, this. This guy's actually pretty cool. What you need to remember when you're getting these DLCs is you're mainly getting it for how the characters look and how much you know about them. Cassian Andor, I think he's a Rogue One character. Yes. I'm noticing that they all have the same blaster. Which is okay. Okay, I have to say I like that little slide. I don't know of any characters that use the same attack pattern, I'm just gonna assume it's unique. Leave it down in the comments if it isn't unique, because I honestly can't think of anyone else, but you guys are more intelligent, so. And next is this dude, and I could have sworn this dude was a Jedi. This is the blind dude. Look at that staff, though. Finally, someone with a unique blaster. I want to actually see how much damage it does. Oh wait, can't do that. Body shot. Okay, this hits incredibly hard. I like him. Okay, and he uses the staff pretty well. Will it clip into walls or anything? Yes, it will. Cool. I like... what? Wait, this guy just clips into walls. Cool. I like good old wall clips. Okay, and I haven't been counting, so I'm just gonna go through, but I think... okay, I think the last dude's in villains, actually. Aha, here he is. The Vector Clinic. I have to say, this guy looks cool. Again, the generic light blaster. But... okay, grenades. Grenades are always a nice addition. Well, his attacks. Okay, kind of just pretty basic. What about... Okay. Yeah, he's kind of just got the basic, villain combos. Long story short, if you're buying Rogue One DLC, you're mainly just buying it because you like the characters, because you can get someone else in the game fairly easily. Most of these are just generic hero characters. And that's kind of what I have to say about all the DLCs out at the moment. I'm actually very excited for Mando Season 2 later this month. Mando Season 2 DLC later this month. But, well, if you're watching this and it's already out, then I've probably made a video reviewing that one. Anyway, guys, I hope you enjoyed my quick little series here about all the DLCs. And, yeah, I think I might do a Dad Account video next. I'm not sure. Bye.